They say the new director can launch objects up to 20 feet.
Bullshit. We've never recorded any distance over 5.
Obviously, you never read the P6 data.
Somebody thought this video would make for great...
Welcome to the research sector of the Federal Bureau of Control. I'm Dr. Casper Darling, head of research. Somebody thought this video would make for great internal communications. I'm looking at you, Mr. Tomasi. So, this is where the magic happens. Anyway, I've been here for 24 years now. I've always been here. And through those years, we've made astonishing discoveries, authored studies of grave importance, and in all this work, there is one thing we know, and that's how little we truly know. Rest assured, we're committed to keep pushing the known laws and borders of reality, and to make the Bureau proud. So, welcome. Assuming you have the necessary clearance, and do follow the safety protocols. Read the manual. Otherwise, bad things will happen. I've been fielding questions recently regarding HRAs. What are they for? Do you always need to wear them? And what's the deal with the hedron resonance anyway? Despite what you may have heard, HRAs are not monitoring devices. We're not tracking your movements or listening to your conversations while you're wearing them. We do that regardless whether or not you're wearing an HRA. Think of them as a life preserver. Only instead of water, the thing HRAs protect you from is classified. One day that classified not water might pour in and you'll be glad you got an HRA keeping you afloat. And if you don't have an HRA, don't worry. It'll be quick and painless. Kidding. I'm kidding. We're making more. I've been feeling questions recently regarding HRAs. What are they for? Need to wear them. What's the deal with the headphone resonance anyway?
She's in trouble. I need to reach her.
I'm averse to using objects of power. I don't want to lean on things I ultimately can't trust. But the ashtray and the cigarette, smoking there forever, have their uses. The ashtray maze they conjure is an impossibly changing labyrinth that no one but the binder, and those the binder invites, can ever pass through. The things we hid in dimensional research, the things Darling studies, the danger and the risk involved, call for every measure of security and protection I could bring to the table. The maze, hands down, is our strongest lock. I gave Darling and his chosen crew license to pass through the maze. Lately, I've started to think I should revoke that license.
The astral plane. Similar to an iceberg, what you see is not what you always get. Regardless, this place is vitally important to the Bureau. Most information on the astral plane is classified, but we can talk in broad strokes, keeping in mind that these are staggeringly complex systems, and simplification does them no justice. Now, the white non-space, the ever-present inverted black pyramid, the board, all linked, intrinsically tied to the oldest house, tied to the director, the process of choosing a director tied to all objects of power in terms of who controls them. Yes. Similar to an iceberg, what you see is not what you always get. Regardless, this place is vitally important to your life. An early hypothesis was that the mindscape of the astral plane is subjective. But that was fast proven wrong. It's an actual place, not a construct of the mind, even though it is with our minds that we enter and experience it. But then one could argue that that's the case with all reality. We've been able to record footage of the astral plane by monitoring the brain activity of those experiencing it. That is the only concrete material that has come out of the astral plane expeditions. Apart from one shocking exception. In the astral plane footage, we're always in the vicinity of the pyramid. We've concluded that this, not the entire plane, is what the board controls. We have glimpsed movement, native species, always in the distance, and yet contact was made. We don't have footage of this, a technical malfunction, but when one of our astralnauts returned, a brain cloud, an astral fugue, had hitchhiked a ride in his head. It ruptured out, killing the subject in question. It's a relentless predator, pursuing thoughts, minds, lethal to those the entity feeds on. Proper containment protocols are to be observed when dealing with it.
They keep that thing here.
Are you still there?
Shit. We're so close. We need to hurry.
An early hypothesis was that the mindscape of the astral plane is subjective. But that was fast proven wrong. It's an actual place, not a construct of the mind, even though it is with our minds that we enter and experience it. But then, one could argue that that's the case with all reality. We've been able to record footage of the astral plane by monitoring the brain activity of those experiencing it. That is the only concrete material that has come out of the astral plane expeditions. Apart from one shocking exception. In the astral plane footage, we're always in the vicinity of the pyramid. We've concluded that this, not the entire plane, is what the board controls. We have glimpsed movement. Native species always in the distance, and yet contact was made. We don't have footage of this, a technical malfunction, but when one of our astralnauts returned, a brain cloud, an astral fugue, had hitchhiked a ride in his head. It ruptured out, killing the subject in question. It's a relentless predator, pursuing thoughts, minds, lethal to those the entity feeds on. Proper containment protocols are to be observed when dealing with it.
To converge here.
Marshall, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you. Who is this?
My name is Jesse Faden. I'm coming to help.
Faden? Hold on. I'm sending the elevator for you. We need to talk.
She got that right. More of you? Really?
Welcome to the party, ma'am. Marshall is right down the hall.
There you are. I was starting to worry. Congratulations on your appointment, Director Faden. I'm Helen Marshall, head of Bureau Operations. Zachariah is dead then, and I assume you found his gun.
Just call me Jesse. Trench told me to find you. He said you could help.
And he told you this through the hotline. Makes sense.
None of this phases her? Really?
Here's the situation. Darling created the HRAs in a lab nearby. We need more if we're gonna survive this attack. My Rangers can't secure the lab alone, not against those things. We need more firepower.
At least she seems to know what's going on here. She could know about Dylan.
I can clear out the hiss. I'll be your firepower.
That's a good answer.
Is she testing me?
Darling has systems in place to protect his labs. This should help you get past them. We'll talk more after you clear out the hiss. Rangers, let her through. We'll have to lock the door behind you. Sorry, but we can't risk a breach.
Thank you.
see Rangers over there. We have to help them.
Thank you. Altered item number 52A. Altered item number 52AE analysis, session 2. I will begin by introducing various stimuli to the item. First, a low voltage electric shock. No response. Next, I will introduce heat via a standard Bunsen burner. No response. Next, a series of solutions will be applied, each with a different value on the pH scale, from 0 to 14. No response to any value. Next, I will attempt to communicate. Can you understand me? Can you understand my words? Quack if you can understand my words. No response. This concludes session 2. We'll need time to prepare further tests. APE analysis, session 2. I will begin by introducing various stimuli to the item. First, a low voltage electric shock. No response. Next, I will introduce heat via a standard Bunsen burner.
This way to the lab? Okay. You must like these HRAs. Sounds like Darling built them. And most of the things around here. If Marshall can't help us with Dylan, he's our next best bet. Assuming he's not dead. Or taken over by the hiss. Me here. Any idea how to make it work?
Hello again, Director. It appears we have a new problem. We need to get the HRA machine working.
I've replaced a couple of spark plugs, but this looks a bit more complicated.
Darling must have had a system. Randomness isn't in his nature. The punch cards. The symbols, the terminals, how do they connect?
I'll see what I can do.
So, we need to find all the punch cards. Each punch card should correspond to a terminal. Whiteboard drawings may be important. Looks like he was working on something to do with these symbols. Prism shattered. Darling's prototypes have a lot of issues. We need a new plan. We need more Blackrock prisms to make this machine work. Darling has another lab, down in the Blackrock processing site and maintenance. That must be where he keeps the prisms.
I've been to maintenance already. I can find my way.
But how long will that take? Nothing here is simple. I need to ask her now, before I go.
I need something from you first. What do you know about Dylan Faden?
I knew this was coming. Lives are at stake here, and we need this machine working to save those lives. Once that is done, Director Faden, then we can talk.
She's right. As much as I don't want to admit it, I'm the only one who can help.
Fine. I'll get the prisms first.
Dylan will have to wait just a little longer.
But don't call me Director. Jesse is fine.
I'll call you Faden. Here, you'll need this keycard.
Thanks. Emily Pope has set up a base in Executive. Once I have the prism, I'll meet you there.
Right. I'll move out immediately. And keep an eye out for Darling. Finding him might be the key to stopping the hiss.
With just one large-scale HRA. It's there now. We are about to be exposed to a different kind of resonance. Hostile, viral, invasive resonance. That's what the Hedron resonance amplifiers are for. Taking the protection Hedron can provide us, and keeping us from being wiped out.
Here, this will lead back to Central Research.
Resonance is the key. Vibration, frequencies, waveforms, fields we didn't know were there. It's physics. These fields in complex interaction, altering reality that comes to contact with them. Hedren is communicating with me. He's trying to warn me of something imminent. I've been using every known method to analyze the data. Exposing myself to it. I'm seeing things and overcome by compulsion. It's not just data, it's protection. It's benign. We are about to be exposed to a different kind of resonance. Hostile, viral, invasive resonance. That's what the Hedren resonance amplifiers are for. Taking the protection Hedren can provide us and keeping us from being wiped out.
Marshall knows something about Dylan. Is he here? Is he all right? HRAs first. They'll help save everyone, including Dylan, once I find him. Can you keep him safe? Like you do with me?
should be open.
We're looking to get a room for the night. Hello?
I don't think anyone's there, honey. Come on. We'll go to that motel we passed a while back.
Okay, we need to find a way to Blackrock Crossing. That's where Marshall said we'd find a prism.
Reminder, if the contents of your workspace have been rearranged, removed, added to, or altered in any other way, you should immediately leave the area while speaking to yourself in a reassuring tone. This will not only keep you calm, but also the room. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you.
During an AWE investigation, our agents discovered a light switch cord in a Butte bungalow closet. They pulled the cord and were instantly transported to the Ocean View Motel and Casino. Dreamlike haze. Inside, they found a door marked with an inverted black pyramid. And just like that, it led back to the oldest house, some 2,000 miles from Montana. Now we're finding the cord in increasing numbers throughout the Bureau. Somehow the two places, they became in tune to each other. The actual physical location of the Ocean View is a mystery. Stepping beyond its walls has so far proven impossible. A place of power, like the oldest house. An AWE investigation. Our agents discovered a light switch cord in a Butte.
Glad to see you're still you.
I'm not doing so.
Hey, thanks for bringing down that, whatever the fuck that was. But we are barely holding on here, boss. How's the situation outside maintenance?
What do I tell him? The truth is harsh, but these people seem familiar with death.
The Hiss are everywhere. Most of the Bureau is lost. We need Blackrock Prism to make more HRAs for any survivors in the safe rooms. I'm here to check Darling's Blackrock lab.
So to recap, death, disaster, and imminent destruction. Another day at the FBC. But Darling's lab is just past Blackrock processing. I got good news and I got bad news on that front. Good news is, it's right down the hall. Bad news is, a Hiss monster has decided to move in, so that's great.
Monster.
That's what the Rangers said. The ones that survived, anyway. But we are just treading water here, and the Hiss keep coming. Salvador would know what to do, but apparently he took a security team into the containment sector just before the lockdown happened, and, well, no one's seen him since. But hey, at least we got you, our fearless leader.
They shouldn't rely on me. They don't know me. They don't know how I failed people.
You've done a good job here, Arish, but you should take your people and get to the base and executive. You can regroup there. I'll go deal with this monster. I'm getting kind of used to them.
Aye, aye, Faden. And be sure to put a bullet in that thing for me.
Ranger Squad Charlie 7 returned from an expedition into the quarry threshold just after 0500 Zulu. Can you please state your names and describe the purpose of your expedition?
Kevin Horowitz, Rupert Wells. Our mission was to map quarry grid
Medic,
coordinates.
What's the damage?
G29.
They've each taken a few
Secondary
days.
Objective,
we need to get them to a
always,
certain station
was
ASAP,
to find a route from the threshold entrance and maintenance
oh, yeah?
to the formation.
They're gonna have to be. Because we are moving out and I am not leaving them behind. Now do what you need to do.
And did you encounter any previously unrecorded event or entity while inside the threshold?
No, nothing. Do you think we should tell him about the mermaid?
Excuse me?
Yeah, the mermaid. Horowitz here found this mermaid in the quarry, just sitting on some black rock. She was singing
this beautiful
song.
You kill a hiss, I buy a shot. Bottom shelf only.
Oh, she was so alluring.
I'd say she was more enchanting than alluring.
Fine, enchanting.
Did you tell your CO about this?
No. Because it didn't happen.
Nothing happened. As usual, the quarry is full of rocks. That's it. Can we go now?
Fuck you guys. Get out of here.
Doing so hot.
You're fine. We'll push through this. The hiss of the lung will do it. Push it back.
Arish wasn't kidding about that monster. You showed me the HRA when I first got here, and the machine that makes them. Can you help me find a prism? Left. What the fuck? Find Darling's lab.
There are areas in the oldest house where under the right... One of the more stable thresholds in the sector. That's where Black Rock comes from.
You heard that too, right?
Dimensional matter.
Black Rock comes from
the
threshold.
Quarry.
So the prisms must be there too.
Contained. Think of it as paranatural lead. Our research involves many dangerous things we absolutely need to keep in check. That's what the Black Rock line firebreaks are about. The panopticon container cells.
Sorry to interrupt, sir, but I need the code with the violator.
Emily. The code's Blackrock 665. Neighbor of the beast. Get it? We can do that again.
This should get us into the quarry. Everything here is crazy. Weird, but it feels right. Like how the world should be. I am in an infinite building leading to different dimensions, and I never want to leave. Even with all the horror, I'm happy. It feels sane. Just the right kind of thing. Elevator's broken. Gotta get down the old-fashioned way. What I expected.
Thank you.
And there it is, right where you led me. The HRAs, the prisms, they mean something to you. I need to get this prism to Marshall before it's too late. HRAs, then Dylan.
Report. All sectors.
Executive is in the...
Had to take a detour into the quarry, but I found plenty. Here.
We will start HRA production immediately. I promised I'd tell you about Dylan once you helped us.
This is it? She knows. 17 years I've waited.
Your brother is here. He was once known as Prime Candidate 6, codename P6. We brought him here after the ordinary event. He was groomed to be the future director. He had talents far beyond any other candidate in the program.
Of course he did. We found you together. We share a bond. Are you with him now?
So you kidnapped him?
We took him in. Your parents vanished along with every other adult in Ordinary. Eventually, his power changed him. There were casualties. He wasn't fit to be the director.
Did you know about this? Is this why you didn't bring me here sooner? Were you keeping me away?
Where is Dylan?
He's kept in the containment sector, in the Panopticon.
My brother. I thought we were the same. What if we are?
I'm going. Now.
I expected as much. I need to go check on something. Something I cannot let the Hiss find. It shouldn't take long, but you must watch the Bureau while I'm gone. And remember, Dylan is dangerous. Do not let him out, Director Faden.
How do I make her stop calling me that? I'm not here for them. Nothing simple here. These people took my brother, but they've accepted me without question. Are they my enemies or my friends? I need to see Dylan. I need to know. I wish you could tell me what you know, explain things. Just stay with me, okay? I could use a friend right now.
Executive is in the process of being fortified, as per your orders. Maintenance is relatively stable. The security employees increased.
Faden's confirmation to the
corrupted organism. Very so. Jesse, when you were down in research, did you run into a Dr. Rhea Underhill?
I didn't. Who is she?
She is a colleague of mine. A researcher studying a kind of extra-dimensional mold growing below research.
Well, I don't like the sound of that.
No one does. Look, I haven't heard from Rhea since the Hiss arrived. Would you mind having a look around for her next time you're in research?
Of course.
Thanks, Jesse. Now, what's on your mind?
I visited the quarry. What's the plan for all that black rock?
The Bureau has used black rock almost exclusively for containment purposes. See, I say, branch out. Instead of boxes, helmets. Instead of blast shields, knives.
Knives?
Yes, knives. So many combat applications. Slicing, stabbing, gouging. Sorry. I've been trying to get Darling to explore combat applications for years. I got a little excited.
Wow. I did not expect that from her. This place is looking good. Arish is making real progress around here.
Right? This place is a fortress. And with him taking care of operations here, I can spend more time analyzing the Hiss. I've been attempting to isolate and neutralize the Hiss resonance in blood samples, but no luck so far.
So you can't reverse it?
Not yet. But perhaps reversing it is too simple. See, if Hiss resonance can rewrite human genetics, then perhaps it's a question of rewriting the Hiss resonance. In theory, that could pave the way for custom human genetic alteration.
I wonder how often the phrase mad scientist is used around here. How is HRA production coming along?
Better than expected. We've already made enough to get people out of a couple safe rooms. They're here, alive, thanks to you. We never would have lasted this long if you hadn't walked in those doors.
You deserve thanks too, of course. We got this place up and running together, Emily. I should be going. Enjoy your data.
Oh, I will.
Physical alterations in his group. Situation report. All sectors.
Executive is in the process of being fortified. It's per your order. employee named Arish has apparently prevented multiple key locations from being research is overrun.
Pope wants us to compile.
No, he's followed you in, right?
Sector. Panopticon. Altered item. Maximum security prison. Dangerous.
Sector, the Panopticon, is home to the altered items we find and contain. It is a maximum security prison. It's a vault for the most valuable treasures on Earth. It's a powder keg big enough to blow this world to dust. A temple, a place of worship filled with idols of angry gods. It's all of these, and none of them. It's something more profound. Unbelievable. Unknowable. Something worse. Altered items. We've found many. They appear mundane, but nothing could be further from the truth. They're all powerful. Dangerous. They press heavy on our minds because that's their nature. They've been altered because we can't stop thinking about them. We put them on altars because they're used to being worshipped. This keeps them calm. We contain them, but they don't want to be controlled. We study them to discover what makes them tick. If this place were ever breached, it would be chaos of biblical proportions.
Thank you.
Someone needs help over...
I'm here. What happened to you?
I got in a little scrap. Name's Horowitz.
Is he gonna be okay?
Don't look at me like that. I'm fine. But Wells is still in there. You gotta get him out.
Who's Wells?
My squad mate. We were hunting a runaway altered item. We followed it down into the clocks.
The clocks?
A threshold. The Bureau sealed it up years back because of all the clocks. We followed the altered item inside, but the way it was acting, we weren't ready. Me and Wells were the only ones to make it to the motel court. He was right behind me, but he never showed up on this side.
I'll go find him. But first, you need to get to a medic.
Wells is the medic. Please, you gotta get him out of there. I'll be fine, really. Roop can patch me up later.
Fine. But I'll be back for you.
I damn well hope so. Just use the motel cord there. It should get you into the clocks. Sorry, the threshold.
This Wells guy can't be far. Those must be the clocks he was talking about.
Come on!
Are you Wells? Your friend asked me to come looking for you.
That must be Horowitz. Glad he got out. I stayed back to help the others. Did a shit job of it, clearly.
You tried. That's enough. Horowitz needs your help now. How do we get out of here?
We should head back through the threshold. We can look for other survivors as we go.
We better hurry. Which way?
Just follow the blood. Let's go.
What's with the clocks?
Threshold effect. This used to be a regular office wing before the threshold manifested. The forces at play in there got a hold of someone's old clock and started duplicating it. Now the office is standing in its clocks all the way to the floor. Find a way around.
Let me see. So, you came down here for an altered item?
The anchor, yeah. Langston said it'd be a simple item retrieval. But the power of that thing had. I've never seen anything like it.
Thank you. Thanks.
That's O'Neill. Shit. No.
When it was clear we couldn't contain the altered item, Horowitz ordered a retreat. We got out, but Hiss were waiting for us. I took Horowitz to the motel court and went back for the others.
That was brave of you.
I'm the medic. It's my job. Almost out of the threshold. Come on. The motel court is on the other side of logistics. Horowitz should still be there. Let's go. Hold on. Something's wrong with him.
Shit.
Horowitz. Oh, God, no.
I'm sorry about your friend.
Thanks. And thanks for coming to get me. Horowitz's HRA must have been damaged in the threshold. Guy never put himself first. At least the anchor altered item is still locked away down in the clocks. I hope it rots down there.
That altered item needs to be dealt with before it hurts anyone else. I should go back down and contain it.
Head to the executive sector, Wells. They could use a medic.
Thank you, Director. I'll go see what good I can do there.
P6 is what the Bureau calls Dylan. His cell's been breached. Has the Hiss found him? Are you there with him? Can you protect him?
Thank you.
been a long time since Dylan and I knew each other. I've wondered about him, what kind of man he'd grow up to be, if things as hard for him as they were for me. Maybe in here, they were even harder.
Oh, hello. Is there something I can help you with?
I'm Jesse, the new director. I need to get inside.
New director? Right. Well, okay. Hello, I'm Frederick Langston, the Panopticon supervisor. It's not the best time for a tour. We have hiss everywhere, numerous cell breaches, and system failures across the board, but you're the director, so here we go. Founded by Zachariah Trench, the Panopticon is our state-of-the-art repository for all altered
items. I don't have time for this.
Power and...
I was told Dylan Faden was kept here. Can you help me find him?
Faden? Sure. Darling wanted him somewhere secure and isolated, away from people. He's in the maximum security cells, upper level. But there's currently a pressing matter, ma'am. We've got an object of power loose in there. It's wrecking the place. The Benikoff TV? It's a real doozy. Salvador took a team in to handle it, but no one's heard from them for hours. This is a Category 5 OOP we're talking about, and if we don't contain it soon, it will tear the Panopticon apart. And we don't want all those altered items getting loose, ma'am. No, trust me.
Dylan's in there.
Open the door, Langston. I'll handle it.
If you say so. I usually tell first-timers not to touch anything, so, just do that. Here, I'll get the door for you. And please, ma'am, call me Fred.
Thanks, Langston.
So many Is the TV back in its box yet? No rush or anything, it's just, you know, an ongoing concern.
Do you like working at the FBC?
Sure. I mean, yeah, the drama's a bit much, but I get better benefits here than I would over at the Postal Service. I checked. Better healthcare. That's not to say I don't like my job, ma'am. Been here over 15 years. No one knows the Panopticon collection better than me. I'm, close to them, in a way.
I can't tell if that's creepy or normal here.
How do you keep the altered items under control?
It depends on the item. Each one has different needs. Ritualistic touches go a long way. Singing to them.
Did he say singing?
Flipping the lights three times, that sort of thing. It's not superstition if it works.
What's the difference between objects of power and altered items?
Think of them like storms. Objects of power are like tropical cyclones or hurricanes for the uneducated. They're big, rare, and scary. Of course, directors can just bind the OOP and become the eye of the storm. Altered items are more like weird thunderstorms. Some may rain frogs, some may rain corn, but they all rain something.
And how does the hiss factor into all that?
It's changing them, making them aggressive. Now they're all raining, I don't know, knives. Knife rain.
Nice metaphor.
Did you work closely with Trench?
Oh, he spent most of his time with Darling and all them. The inner circle. Not that I care.
Trench certainly had his favorites.
He did stop in occasionally to scowl and smoke. Did you know the Bureau has a no-smoking policy? It does. Just not for Trench. Still, he is the one who put aside funding for the Panopticon. The man did have vision.
How did you get this job?
Started as a junior agent, because my uncle knew a guy. From there, I got put on a desk until an accident left the containment sector severely understaffed. At which point, I got bumped up to management. Put in a steady 8 hours a day for another 10 years, and voila, supervisor.
I just picked up a gun. Or a gun picked me.
I'll see you later, Langston.
I'll be here, like always.
The Panopticon. Dylan's close. but that object of power might wreck this place before I find it. Something went wrong with the Bureau's plan to make Dylan the next director. Marshall made it sound like it was all Dylan's fault, but how much of it was what the Bureau did to him? I don't think she's telling me everything.
Object at all times, or it deviates. My ship replacement never showed up. Can you help me?
Damn. I can't. I'm sorry. There's an emergency. I'll come back. I promise.
Okay. Okay, just don't forget. I can't stare at this thing much longer.
Thank you.
That's the object of power. I need to cleanse it.
Thank you.
against the hiss. No one here does. Okay, the TV. Another object of power going nuts. Here we go again. With the TV. Now I can find Dylan.
Thank you.
Dylan. He's so close.
Can you hear me? Jesse. Are you there, Jesse?
Emily? He's gone. Dylan isn't here. He might be nearby. Or maybe the hiss got to him. I don't know.
Jesse, listen. Dylan's here, with us. He just walked in. He says he is giving himself up. He's been affected by the hiss, but he is different than the others. We must isolate him.
I'm on my way. We need to get back. I have to see my brother.
I won't take up too much of your time today, Dylan. Like I said, I want to talk about Jessie, your sister.
What about her?
I just want to get your perspective. What do you think of her? What kind of person is she? That sort of thing.
I adored my sister. When I was little, I mean, back in ordinary.
And you don't anymore?
When I first got here, sure. I'd always hope she'd come too. Find me, to take me home. We went everywhere together. Why should this be any different? Casper said she could come, too, to the Bureau, if she wanted to. But she never did.
Why do you think that is?
Because she didn't care about me. She always wanted to be out on her own, seeing the world. She always said so. I guess she got what she wanted.
Great. So, she wanted to see the world. Did she ever mention any place in particular?
Why?
We like to ask questions around here, you know that. Any particular cities, towns, landmarks, anything like that?
I don't remember.
What about family friends? Were you close with anyone living outside of ordinary?
I'm done with this. Tell Casper I want pizza for lunch today.
Dylan, wait. We're not... End of session.
Oh my god, did she have to write everything in a made-up gibberish code? Fucking Martian. I don't think I ever told you this, but I was actually on the path to being a ranger once. Did the whole boot camp thing. Even got rookie status. Anyway, not the point. My own ranger squad was a great bunch. There was six plus me. Remus, Hazard, Cho, Guy, Hepton, Stahl, and Thompson. They were supposed to get back from an expedition yesterday. We had beers and wings planned. Problem is, they weren't here when Darling handed out the HRAs.
Then they had nothing protecting them from the Hiss.
You see, they prepped for the worst, but I think that we're already past that. We all wore these pouches around our neck, and I really don't want the Hiss to get them. Could you find them for me? The squad would have come back through maintenance, but they probably spread out from there.
I'll keep an eye out for them, Arish. And I won't let them stay Hiss.
What's the deal with BlackRock?
Oh, fuck. Don't get me started on BlackRock. You know, ever since research found out that it blocks paranatural stuff, they have just been parading dangerous materials in and out of the fucking quarry. Fucking lab coats, man. Love making my job harder.
Sounds like there's some tension between departments.
Still, at least the quarry's got a good view of the night sky. You know, me and Salvador used to have after-work beers down there.
What do you know about Dr. Darling?
About as much as anybody, I guess. Head of research. Loves to hear himself talk. All of those science types absolutely do. He's been acting a little bit psycho recently. Although HR told me not to use that word, so...
Everyone thinks finding Darling will lead us to the answers. But if he's completely lost it, then what help could he be?
You're security, right? Do you work with Rangers?
Not often. Rangers are specially trained in threshold reconnaissance and ground zero AWE response. Security is more interested in the dangers inside the Bureau.
They must see some weird stuff out there.
Oh yeah, definitely. You know, every week they are tackling things that were previously unknown to the human experience. Most Rangers, they retire due to cognitive collapse. I looked up the medical definition. Not fun.
How does the Bureau handle thresholds?
Handle might be a bit of an optimistic way to put it. Marshall sends her rangers in to map them, check growth rates, locate epicenters, take samples, measure stuff, basically.
Sounds like he's done his homework.
Now, down in maintenance, thresholds are used just like any other tool. Lab coats mine BlackRock from one, maintenance siphons water from another. We use it for pretty much everything, except drinking.
Why don't you drink it?
Do I even want to know?
Yeah, a lot of time we find these little chunks in it. It's pretty gross.
I didn't want to know.
What do you think of Marshall?
Marshall? Marshall's a fucking badass. Rangers could not ask for a better leader. She's a little, intense, but given the stuff she's seen, I'm not surprised. She does have a bad habit of disappearing, though.
Where does she go?
Last time she vanished, I did some digging into the security logs. I found camera footage of her entering the quarry. She was down there alone for days. Now, typically that's not allowed, but Marshall is kind of above the rules.
I wonder what she finds so interesting in the quarry.
I have to go.
Me too. You're not the only one who's busy, you know.
From the HRAs is purely antithetical to every variant of the hiss signaling range.
It's happening. After all these years, Dylan is here. But am I too late?
How is he? I need to know.
He's clearly been affected by the hiss, but it's different than any other manifestation we've recorded. Maybe what makes you so special is genetic. He was a prime candidate. Or maybe it's Polaris protecting him, something else affecting the situation. I need to run tests. He seems more in control, more present.
I want to see him.
My brother. Or is he?
Of course. Now, Marshall set up an HRA-warded cage to contain him. It's on the upper floor, up the stairs.
Okay, I need to go.
Jesse, be careful.
Director restored HRA production. They're already getting other survivors to come safe. Great.
Marshall abandons us.
Did you see that hiss they marched through here? Why the fuck didn't we put a bullet in that thing's head?
I
What do you know about this Arish guy?
I heard some rangers saying he saved the Marines.
Push the fenders through the surface into the wet. You've always been in there. You are. This is the patrol. We stand around you while you dream. You can almost hear our words, but you forget. Through time, the thunderstorm distorts you. Happiness comes. You are a worm through time.
Shit.
The thunderstorm distorts you.
That's Dylan.
White pearls.
Can you hear me?
Red in the eye.
Oh, come on, Dylan. I'm here. I found you.
The surface into the wet. You've always been in there. You are. This is the patrol.
Do you know who I am? Oh, you know me. Say it.
You are Dylan Faden's sister.
He's talking in the third person. Always a good sign. Do you know who you are?
Not Dylan. Trench and Darling made sure of that. I'm P6. P6. But I'm better now. The hiss made me better.
Push the fingers through the surface into the wet. You've always been the new you. You want this to be
true. Can you stop that? Please. Not exactly the reunion I'd hoped for.
It feels good to say those words. I want to say them. They sound good. They make me feel good. Don't you want to say them too?
No. Fuck off, no. You need to help me get this thing out of his head. If he is still in there, if there is anything left, you have to help me.
You! You came in through the hole in you. We let you in. You've always been here. The only child. A copy of a copy of a copy of a copy.
Stop it!
Orange Peel!
Shit! Shit! He can see you. This is not safe.
We found Polaris together with my sister when we were very small, in ordinary. In the desert, through the door opened up by the slide projector. But she didn't help when Trench took me away. She didn't give me any powers. All the powers are my own powers. She didn't help when they locked me up for years.
After the song time for applause, we build you till nothing remains. The air cracks and the truth will emerge out of you. You are home.
The Bureau brought the slide projector back here with me. And the Bureau did what the Bureau does. They used it. And they found. They opened the door up to the hiss. That's the only thing I can thank them for.
There. There it is. We stopped the altered world event in ordinary when we shut down the slide projector. And now the projector's here.
An earworm is a tune you can't stop humming in a dream, baby. Baby, baby, yeah. Just plastic. So safe. Nothing to worry about. Funny.
I welcomed the hiss. I let it in. To get rid of her. The hiss set me free. Polaris is using you. The Bureau is using you. You are a puppet.
You can almost hear our words, but you forget.
If we shut off the slide projector, maybe that will stop the hiss.
Your regulations.
Maybe it's not too late for my brother.
You must see the truth for yourself, Jesse. Sister. The horrible truth about the Bureau. The hiss is the better option. Go to the Prime Candidate program in the containment sector. I have the keycard to get you there. Salvador wanted me to have it.
Wanted? Bullshit. I saw what the Hiss did to Salvador. What it turned him into.
Okay, Dylan. I'll go. I want to see the truth for myself.
I'll go. But only to look for this lie projector. You can help me. We can end this.
You are a worm through time. You are a worm through time. The thunderstorm distorts you. Happiness comes. White pearls, but yellow and red in the eye. Through a mirror, the inverted is made red. Leave your inside light.